So first we're given this problem and we're supposed to switch the order of integration. We're gonna switch this to being in terms of y equals x rather than x equals y. We have the y values here. So I'm gonna first graph the region that this expresses and then we can get to switching them. So we have from 0 to 4, so I know it's going to come up here. So we have y equals 0, which is this line right here, y equals 4. Then we have x equals positive square root of y, which is going to look like this. We have x equals negative square root of y, which is going to look like this. Since it's from 0 to 4, it's going to come up like that. And this is our region that we're trying to find. So now that I know this region, that shape right there looks pretty familiar. So I'm going to be able to convert this. And I'm going to first grab one of these equations here. x equals square root of y. And I'm going to isolate for y this time. So we're going to get y equals x squared. So that actually covers both of these limits. As you see, it's a parabola, so it's pretty simple to do. I'm going to rewrite that from here. So we start, this is starting from 0 now and going from x squared to 4 rather than from 4 to x squared. Our limits on the sides, the x squared, the parabola is going to touch at negative 2 and at positive 2, so now we have our x limits. We have our x squared y dx, that doesn't change. Actually, the dx does change, it turns to dy dx. And now we can begin integrating. This is a lot easier to integrate now. So first it's in terms of y. So I'm going to take the antiderivative of that, and that will be 1 half x squared y squared from x squared to 4. So I have to plug in my limits now. So, this turns to 16, and 16 over 2 is 8, so we're left with 8x squared minus 1 half x4, and I'm going to simplify this over here. So now we can integrate it in terms of x. I'm just going to do that right under here. Now we're going to plug in our limits. And I'm gonna have to think about these numbers really quick. I'm gonna move it over here. So we have, that'll be 8, so 64 thirds minus 32 tenths minus, and that's gonna be negative 8, so minus negative 64 thirds. And then that'll be minus negative 32 tenths. So I'm gonna combine these now. I'll have to move to the left again. So it'll be 128 thirds minus, oh wait, those will cancel out actually. We have to distribute there, so it'll still be minus 64 tenths. And you could combine these even further, but that's a little bit more math. I don't want to take this too long.